Joining me now is Emanuel Pastreich, and he's from the Asia Institute and the director there. Thanks so much for joining us, Emanuel. Now, tell us, what do we know about the testing of this weapon and similar reports of tests from North Korea?
Well, I think our knowledge is remains quite limited as to the actual weapon. I would suggest rather that we really, which is why are we on the edge of a weapons race in Northeast Asia, and what do we need to do to turn this around, to get out of a competition and to start to move towards a environment in which we can reduce the number of weapons being deployed.
And Emanuel, there were no photos or video this time. What does this tell us?
Oh, well, it tells us that it's probably part of a very small scale strategic negotiation between various parties in North Korea and the United States and elsewhere concerning things which we know nothing about. So the question there would be, how do we have an actual discussion or debate about the future of Northeast Asia and its security, which actually involves ordinary people and people who actually know what they're talking about, as opposed to ignorant politicians?
So on that note, then, where do you think a possible third summit with the leaders of North Korea and the U.S. stands right now?
Oh, right. Well, I'm sorry. You may have picked the wrong American to interview. I really could care less about the next summit. I'm interested in a scientific discussion about what it takes to denuclearize Northeast Asia and reduce nuclear weapons. That cannot possibly be achieved through a meeting between Donald Trump, who's essentially unilaterally pulled out of every treaty on nuclear weapons, and Kim Jong-un. But I welcome the opportunity for an honest discussion of this. And since I'm not a professional fortune teller, I won't even try and guess when and where the next summit will be.
No, that my question was where the possibility. But you know, let's talk.
Oh, I have no idea.
No problem. Yeah. And then let's talk about then getting rid of weapons in the area of Asia.
Right.
What do you practically think needs to be done away from diplomacy then?
Well, I really appreciate your giving me that question, because it's totally ignored in the debate globally about the. North Korea and Northeast Asia. So the real danger is that this provocations between the United States and North Korea will lead to a general nuclear arms race in the region and in the world. Of course, this time around, it won't just be the Soviet Union and United States, right? It will include many other countries and many scientists and experts, people actually know what they're talking about, are deeply, deeply worried about the risk of nuclear war, which could be easily triggered by just a stupid mistake. So North Korea is a little part of that problem. We cannot deny that. But the larger problem has been the unilateral decision of the Trump administration, and it has much support within the military system in the United States to essentially give up on any effort to control the spread of nuclear weapons, and to insist that North Korea should adhere to the Non-Proliferation Treaty when the United States is in blatant violation of it, as are increasingly a number of countries associated with the United States.
Okay. Emanuel, great to have your perspective and analysis. Emanuel Pastreich joining us from Seoul. Thank you.